Yo, what's up, everyone? Welcome back. Season 3 of Modern Warfare 3 officially launches on April 3rd, and we just got the official roadmap, which surprised me big time, because not only are we going to be getting a whopping 6 6v6 maps this season, we're also going to be getting a handful of perks, a handful of weapons, even more aftermarket parts, and just so much more. So we're going to be talking about that here in this video today. If you enjoy, of course, don't forget to leave a like. Let's begin by talking about the 6 maps. At the launch of Season 3, we're going to be getting 4 maps, and then 2 of them will be dropping in our mid-season update. It is unheard of in this day and age of Call of Duty that we would get more than 3 maps at the launch, especially when it comes to 6v6. So I definitely feel like Sledgehammer has been cooking this season. Let's go ahead and see what they had to say for the maps that are coming. First up at launch, we're going to be getting a brand new map called Six Star. This takes place in Dubai. At the very top of a skyscraper resort, you got a pool and a bar that you're able to fight through, a lounging area, an outdoor area. This allows excellent access from around the map. There's a curved connecting corridor, so you're going to be able to use submachine guns, shotguns, ARs, and yes, even snipers due to the long sight lines in certain areas. But with the map being as curved as it is, this allows for easier access through the center and some more close quarters combat. And I think that this is going to be quite a fun map to play. And once again, this is brand new. It's a medium-sized map for 6v6. The second map we're getting at launch is called Emergency. This is considered a small map, and it says here, force your foes to visit the ICU after dominating them in this Arizonian medical facility. Nestled on the summit of a remote mountain range, a nearby town lies in the wooded valley below. The entire area is a scene of a major conflagration with black smoke billowing from the valley below, while the State Disease Control Agency facility has seen evidence of fierce fighting. The flow of the map is via an exterior forecourt, the interior reception lobby, and a medical laboratory, offering longer sightline opportunities for both of the ground and atop parked vehicles. But this one's looking pretty sweet, and I gotta say this, does anyone else get Carrier vibes from this image, Carrier from BO2? Do you guys remember that map? Here's like a side-by-side. I don't know why, but at first when I saw just this image, I thought they were remaking Carrier, and yeah, that would have been awesome as well. We did get a remaked map though, or I should say a remastered map. For those of you that weren't around for the DLC season of Call of Duty Vanguard, we had a map there called Sphere, and this is what it looked like. That has now been reimagined into Grow House, and yes, this is also coming at launch. This is a 6v6 map, and Sphere was a fun one. This has a few different pathways that you could take. It's a 3-lane design. In the center is where a majority of the fighting is going to be happening, but along the outskirts, there's also a vent system that can help you get into the center while also trying to flank with different types of staircases and ladders that you're able to use in order to flank the enemies. Overall, looking pretty similar, but of course, it's been reimagined and remastered for this game a little bit differently, and I'm looking forward to playing that because it was one of my favorite maps from the DLC season. Next up, and the final map that we're going to be getting at launch is called Tanked. This is a repurposed map, and what that means is we are going to be seeing a location from the Vondel Zoo. This is an after-hours situation, so the time of day is going to be a little bit different, the lighting is going to be a little bit different, and things have been updated quite a bit in order to fit the 6v6 multiplayer flow and demand. So it's going to be similar vibes to what we experienced in Vondel, but it's going to be different in the sense that it needs to fit the 6v6 protocol, I guess you could say. So the action is mainly going to take place on the ground level, but there will be a second level that has a reptile housing enclosure, which I think is going to be pretty cool. Moving forward, our fifth map, which is going to appear in our mid-season update, is also a repurposed area from Warzone. This time it's called Checkpoint, and this is coming from Rebirth Island. It's a small military comms outpost, and it features a central checkpoint, an interior armory, storage locker room, and garage. If you played Rebirth Island, this area is going to look very familiar to you. Obviously, it's been repurposed specifically for multiplayer, and it's considered a small-sized map. Now, finally, in our mid-season update, we're also going to be getting another brand new map. It's considered small to medium size. This one's called Grime, And this map takes place in a derelict London canal, well away from Big Ben and the bright lights of England's capital city. So you're not going to see Piccadilly here. It's going to be a little bit different. But honestly, from the screenshots we got, there's certain areas that are super bright and colorful and vibrant because of the graffiti that we see on the walls. But there's also some rundown and dark interiors that look kind of creepy. Outside of that, there is some water combat that can take place by the docks. It's murky and kind of trashy, but overall, a very interesting looking map based off the screenshots that we have here. Now, I will say this, just want to share my opinions on the remastered and repurposed locations from Rebirth Island and Vondel. This doesn't bother me as much as it would if they were to have launched with just those three things. Like, if they launched with a remastered map and two areas from Warzone experience, yeah, that would kind of frustrate me, like, wow, we didn't get anything new. But in this case, we're getting a mixture of brand new experiences that we've never had a chance to play with some reimagined and repurposed areas. And in my opinion, that's okay because it just bolsters the entire season. It gives us more to look forward to. And at the launch of season three, getting four of these 6v6 maps is just unheard of in this climate. So even with a remaster, I'm okay with that. And I would really love to know what you think about it down below in the comment section. That was a huge surprise to see on the roadmap. I was not expecting it. Coming at launch, we're also going to be getting the return of Capture the Flag. And then within the launch window, One in the Chamber, a party game, is going to be coming through. So maybe not the first week, but the next couple of weeks after Season 3 launch, we're going to end up seeing One in the Chamber. Another game mode is coming through, and this is happening in our mid-season update. It's called Minefield. This is definitely one of those sillier, limited-time modes because they even describe it as, in the same way that Season 2's Horde Point was Hard Point, but with zombies, think of Minefield as multiplayer, but with mines. So yeah, it's literally just going to be multiplayer with proximity mines all over the place. Sledgehammer goes on to say that this game variant will be in a variety of modes like Kill Confirm, Domination, and Hardpoint. Minefield uses the same rules as the mode in question, but with one important addition. When you defeat a rival player, a proximity mine is dropped at their feet. This mine cannot be picked up, and it remains deadly to the enemy team, but not to any friendly teammates. As the action heats up, the scattered mines are dropped across the map to ramp up the action to a cacophony of chaos. Watch your step out there. So if you end up killing an enemy and the teammates are surrounding the enemy, a proximity mine is going to drop right on them, and boom goes the dynamite. There's going to be a ton of bodies flying everywhere. This sounds like a super chaotic mode. I am looking forward to jumping in and trying it out for myself. In our mid-season update, we're also going to be getting another mode called Escorts. And in the description of this mode, they basically call back to the Warzone veterans who remember Payload. But I would even say, look back even further to BO3, to something like Safeguard, where you transport a robot from point A to point B. This is going to be in multiplayer, so it's going to be a little bit different. But they say here, everybody has unlimited respawns. You face off on a variety of maps, with one side protecting the MAW as it maneuvers through the map. The MAW is something that was also featured recently in the newest Season 2 war map. It's the same idea, the same type of robot. So this is what you're going to be transporting. The attacking team is going to try to override the goal to ensure the vehicle reaches its destination, while the defending team is to try and disable the vehicle by any means. And then, similar to what we've seen in the past, once the first game of the match is completed, the teams will swap, and the side with the quickest vehicle takedown wins. So this is definitely a mode right up my alley. I'm looking forward to it. I'll definitely try Capture the Flag. It was never one of my favorite modes to play, but it was interesting in the past, especially when you look all the way back to the original Black Ops, and we had pro perks that needed to be unlocked by playing modes like Capture the Flag. So it really got people playing different modes. Same thing that we saw with the other seasons with ranked play. Multiplayer ranked play Season 3 is coming through. There's going to be new rewards to earn, new stickers, charms, gear, camouflage patterns. And then there's also going to be ranked rewards coming for the Warzone mode as well. But there's still more stuff for multiplayer. This is going to be a multiplayer-centric video because we're going to be getting some new perks and equipment, both in the launch and during the season. So coming at launch, we're going to be getting 5 new perks for multiplayer, and that starts with the Gunslinger Vest. This is a secondary weapon specialist vest, meaning you get no primary slot, but you get 2 secondary weapon slots. This vest will also allow you to have 2 tacticals, 1 lethal, and a field upgrade, alongside a pair of gloves, boots, and 2 pieces of gear. While wearing this vest, you'll also receive benefits to secondary weapons only. This includes refresh stamina on kills, improved reloading speed, reloading while sprinting, increased weapon swap speed by a minimum of 40%, and you spawn with max ammo, and you'll have your maximum ammo in your reserve as well. So this is a very powerful perk, especially if you're looking to work on those secondary weapons and or maybe you're trying to do something else. The second perk is our modular assault rig, and what this is going to do is give you lethal and tactical scavenger. So you'll get 2 tacticals, 2 lethals, and a field upgrade, alongside gloves, boots, and a piece of gear. You'll get maximum reserve ammo and resupply lethals and tacticals from dead players. I'm a little concerned about this, especially when it comes to those smaller maps. You really don't got much to lose. You don't really need to use like Ghost on those smaller maps. So having this will just provide you with basically unlimited thermites, unlimited grenades, unlimited semtex. It kind of makes me worried for the future of shipment. Next up, we have our compression carrier. This is a brand new vest. You get assisted healing and gas protection. Your equipment slots include just a lethal. You're not going to be able to take a field upgrade or tactical with this. You'll get gloves, boots, and gear, but the bonus is you'll immediately regenerate health after a kill or objective capture, and you'll see reduced effects from gas grenades. So this is effectively giving you the quick fix perk at the cost of losing a lot of your equipment and gear slots. The third new perk is a pair of boots called the reinforced boots. It makes you immune to movement reduction effects. The fourth new perk coming at launch is called the high gain antenna. And what this does is it gives you a zoomed out mini map for you and nearby allies. Enemies will remain on the radar longer for you and your nearby allies if your ally has the CCT comms vest perk equipped. And on top of that, you will see nearby ally radar pings from Intel Jacker and compass indicators from nearby ally signal jammers. So this is really all about reconnaissance and giving you the best overview of the map while trying to take in all of the information surrounding you. But it seems like this perk really relies on your teammates utilizing a lot of other perks for it to really work properly. And I'll be honest with you, I don't really see too many people running specific things like the signal jammer. So maybe it'll help, maybe it won't. I guess if you're running in a full squad, you can set this up to really make it a god tier perk as long as everybody's using their proper equipment and perks. In our mid-season update, we're going to be getting some new tactical equipment. And first up, we have the EMD mine. This is a proximity mine that sticks to surfaces, and once triggered, the mine will shoot out tracker devices that reveal the enemy location and direction until the enemy actually removes them themselves. So this is not too crazy. It's very similar to the EMD tactical grenade in which you have to throw at the enemy and hopefully you stick it. This is just the mine version, so it's going to explode and give away their position until they physically remove the tracker from their body. Otherwise, you'll see them on the minimap kind of similar to an advanced UAV. The last piece of tactical equipment we're going to be getting in our mid-season update is called the EVG, Enhanced Vision Goggles. This is going to allow your operator to toggle between normal vision and enhanced vision with integrated targeting highlighting, and it has a limited battery, so you're not going to be able to just run this all the time. You have to use it sparingly until the battery dies. I would assume every time you respawn, the battery will be recharged and give you a chance to utilize it again. Now, I do wonder, because it doesn't mention here at all, if you're using it, if it gives off a sound effect, or if it gives you off on the radar, or if it gives you away in another way. But as you can see from the screenshot we have here, it kind of highlights the enemies that are in front of you while simultaneously highlighting everything else. So I don't know how beneficial this is going to be. I guess we'll have to wait till the mid-season update and check it out for ourselves. But yeah, this kind of looks interesting. It's kind of like having a portable thermal in a way. So we'll see how this does. And of course, I'm sure there's going to be a lot of ways to block this if you're a player. Like, I'm sure there's going to be certain perks that block this entire thing. So Yeah, we'll see once we get there. Moving on forward, let's talk about the new weapons coming with Season 3. There are going to be four of them in total, three of which are at launch, and this includes the FJX Horus. This is a submachine gun, an ultra-compact SMG with the best-in-class close-quarters combat damage and mobility. It's going to allow you to move quickly. You're going to have crazy fire rate. Attaching a high-capacity magazine is really going to let you pray and spray. So this is going to be a good close-quarters weapon, and I'm looking forward to seeing how this one does. Next up, we have a sniper rifle, the return of something special, and that is the Moors. For those of you that played back during the day of Advanced Warfare, the Moors was the go-to sniper, and this time around, we got it back. And in my opinion, it's looking better than ever. This is a single-load rail gun, and it delivers a high-damage payload with excellent velocity and penetration. I love the fact that they're bringing back some Advanced Warfare weapons. It doesn't end there. Let's continue on. The other thing we're going to be getting at launch is a new melee weapon. It's called the Gladiator. This is a compact, concealable punch knife that was used by gamblers and politicians. So there you go. You're going to be able to just stab somebody in the neck. But really, the thing that I'm looking forward to is our mid-season weapon. We have the return of the Ball 27, the BAL. This thing is returning in all of its glory. It's coming during a mid-season update. This is a bullpup prototype weapon designed to increase fire rate over time while the trigger is squeezed. The first four shots are slower to fire, but highly accurate. And the difference between this BAL versus the one that we had in the past, if you guessed it, you're right, it is, of course, the gunsmith. So we're going to have quite a bit of customization when it comes to this weapon this time around. I'm looking forward to it. I really am. I think that this was one of my least favorite weapons to encounter back during Advanced Warfare. But once you got the Obsidian Steed, if you guys remember the blueprints and how those worked, that thing was crazy. So I really do wonder what type of blueprints we're going to get with this thing this time around. I have a feeling that this opens the door to classic bundles all around, and I guess we'll see what happens. And speaking of classics, we are going to be getting the return of the dual model 1887 in the form of an aftermarket part. Let's talk a little bit about that, because Season 3 is going to be bringing us 8 new aftermarket parts, and many of these are going to be unlocked via the weekly challenges, kind of similar to how they were dished out during the first season in Season 2. Let's go ahead and run down the list and talk about what we can expect. We have the Jack Cutthroat. This is going to be an attachment that works on various weapons. It's a 3D printed stock that provides unrivaled combination of speed and stability while aiming down sight. Next, we have the Jack Revenger Kit. This is going to be available for the BP-50. It converts it into a CQC 9mm conversion. It's a short receiver and high-capacity magazine that works better at close range than long range. The Jack Jawbreaker is going to be available for the KV Broadside Shotgun. It converts the shotgun into a hard-hitting automatic battle rifle. Then we can look forward to the Jack Shadow Titan kit, which is going to be available for the Bruin Mark 9. This is going to take the LMG and compact it. It's also going to add an integrated suppressor. It's going to turn it into a light support weapon chambered in 300 blackout. So that's going to hit pretty dang hard. I'm looking forward to it. Then we have the Jack Patriot, specifically for the M16. It's going to convert it to be fully automatic. Alongside that, it's also going to have a heavy ported barrel to provide superior recoil control and firing aim stability. Then we got the Wardens, which is, of course, going to be the Model 1887s. It's for the Lockwood Mark II. It's going to take this marksman rifle and turn it into akimbo lever-action shotguns. I'm really hoping that this one comes sooner than later because I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be part of a weekly unlock challenge. Then we have the Jack Atlas kit. This is for the AMR-9. It converts it into an extremely lethal and accurate 5-round burst carbine chambered in 5.56. And then finally, we have the Photonic Charge Barrel for the Moors. We're getting ourselves an aftermarket part for the new weapon. This is a hyper-advanced barrel that is more than simply a barrel. Holding the trigger charges the rifle, and releasing it fires a single high-power energy projectile. And I'm looking forward to this. It says that it's a redacted unlock, so I'm going to assume it's going to be part of some event. And that has me really, really looking forward to what's going to be happening with the other weapons. But the Moors looking pretty sweet. And alongside all of that, we are also going to be getting some new events, including the Godzilla Kong crossover battle for Hollow Earth. We have the Blaze Up event coming in Modern Warfare 3. Warzone is going to be getting an exclusive event called High Trip. And we're also going to be getting another event called Vortex, the Virus Mainframe, which is going to be happening in season. So our launch window events include Blaze Up and the High Trip, which is all kind of 420 related. And speaking of which, when it comes to 420 relation, we're also going to be getting a Tracer pack. Cheech and Chong. Wasn't expecting to see that, but here we are. We're going to have both of these operators voiced by, you guessed it, the actual Cheech Marin and Tommy Chong, which I think is pretty cool. The Godzilla Kong crossover is happening again, and that brings us some new operator skins. These ones look pretty interesting, and I got to say, it kind of reminds me of Mortal Kombat. So, yeah, make of that what you will. Alongside that, similar to what they did with the previous Kong event back during Vanguard, they're going to be doing a bundle collection type of deal, which means if you purchase multiple bundles, you will get different bonus items along the way, which once again, I just don't recommend that to anybody. It's just so much money. Other bundles that are coming include this 420 sloth, a fucking velociraptor, a brain in a jar, and this robot dude. I mean, we're finally going to have dinosaurs in Call of Duty. That's pretty cool. But at the same time, this is crazy, man. Some of these skins that they're doing is just wild. Think about the detail that's going into these bundles. And then think about what Zombies is getting shit on. It just bothers the shit out of me. Does anyone else get bothered by that? Anyway, since the new season is beginning, we're going to have a seasonal camouflage that you can get by completing all the different weeks of challenges. And once you do that, you will then get this camo right here, which looks pretty cool. I'm definitely here for it. The season 2 weekly challenges have come to a close, by the way. So if you haven't got that zombie rot camo, now's your opportunity to go back through, complete those challenges if you haven't done it yet, and earn the camouflage pattern. It's actually really nice. It's completely animated, and I definitely recommend it for those of you that are looking for free content that you can earn simply by playing the game. Now, I don't know about all of you, but I don't even know if you made it to the end of this video. I didn't realize how long it was, so I just looked at the time code. But I gotta say, I'm pretty impressed with what Sledgehammer's bringing this season. Considering everything that's been going on with their studio being closed and them moving to work from home, and it's just really an interesting situation that we find ourselves in, especially right after a major session of being laid off. So many employees within Activision Blizzard got laid off. So this is not at all what I was expecting for season 3, but I'm definitely happy they managed to pull it off. So we'll have to see what else is in store for us, especially when it comes to these little events that are going to be happening throughout. But I gotta say, I'm impressed. I'm looking forward to it. I, for once in a long while, am excited to jump back in. I'm looking forward to playing with the Moors. I'm looking forward to progressing the Battle Pass. And more importantly, I'm looking forward to playing Call of Duty again, which is kind of something I haven't been able to say in a long time. But anyway, that's it. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. If you all enjoyed this video here, do me a favor, drop a like on it, subscribe for more videos coming soon, and of course, I will see you all on the next one. Peace.